Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to count the number of vowels present in a string in Python. So let's get started. So first let us input a string. So let s be my string. So I'll go here, s equal to, it's going to be only input, okay? Don't type int of input because we are inputting a string and not an integer. So it's going to be enter a string, okay? This is now fine. So for this program we will be using a for loop. And with the help of that for loop, we will be able to iterate each and every character present in our string s. And we will be having a if condition inside the for loop that basically checks if that particular character is a vowel, that is A or E or I or U. Okay, simple. So now let's begin with the first step, that is a for loop. So it's going to be for I in range 0, len, and inside that you need to pass your string variable name. So this is now fine. Yeah. And in the next line, as I told you, here we will be having a if condition, and in the if condition we will be checking whether each and every character present in a string is a vowel. So it's going to be s of I, okay? So this, with the help of this, we will be able to access each and every character, like individual characters present in a string. So it's going to be s of I equality double equal to, okay, equal to a, and after that we will be using the or operator. So let me just now copy this and we'll be like pasting it multiple number of times. So I'll paste it. I think we can come to the next line. I don't think, okay. Okay, I'll just paste it again. So where is this? So after pasting it this many times, I'll just go here and change it as E. This is going to be I. And this is going to be O. And this is going to be U. Yeah, this is now fine. So yeah, there are no things. So it's going to be till U, okay. So I need to have A, E and I, O, U, and don't add any R, okay, just close the bracket after this. So what we are basically checking is that we are checking if that particular character present in a string satisfies any one of these conditions, okay. You need to satisfy this one, you need to satisfy this one, you need to satisfy this one. So what R operator does is that it returns true if any one of these conditions is true, okay. It's exact opposite to AND operator. AND operator returns true only when both the conditions or both the expressions are true. But OR operator returns true if any one of the condition is true. So if this is true, it will still going to return true. So this is how you do it. So once you are done with this, in next line we will be having a counter. We can iterate through each and every character present in a string. We can like determine if that particular character is a vowel or not. So now we are good. But what is the ultimate aim of our program? To count the number of vowels. So for that we will be having a counter. So let count equal to 0, just initialize to 0 to avoid any garbage or junk values. And just come over here. I think I didn't add the colon. Yeah, colon. So I'll just move this entire code to the next line because I'm not having space. If you're having space, you can just have it in a straight line. So I'll just hit enter over here. So this is now fine. So I will just have this count, okay? Count equal to count plus 1. So be careful with the indentation, okay? I'm just having this in a separate line because I'm not having space over here. Have this in a separate like indentation. So it'll be like two tab spaces, okay, and here there must be one tab space. Have it in a straight line if you have space. So that's it, that's the code pretty much. And now I will just print count. Simple, that's the code, guys. So I'm saving it now and running it. So interesting. So I'll just enter hello, hi. So this has like around, okay, oh, it's hello, I'll remove this here. So this has around E, O, and three I's, so that is five vowels. I hit enter, so I'll be getting the output as five. So simple, guys. First, what happens is that h will be taken here, s of I will be h, and it will be compared with this entire statement. This is false because h is not here. Though all the conditions will be false, none of them will be true. It count is still 0. E comes and E is over here, right? S of I equal to 0. This condition becomes true and it goes inside the if condition. So count will become incremented by value 1. So after that, that's it. Simple. After that, I think you can do the rest of stuff. L, it won't, the condition is false. Another L condition is false. O condition is true because O is over here. This is true. It comes here. Count was already 1 because of our value E. Now count becomes 2 because of O again. So count equal to 1 plus 1, 2. Then 3 I's, it's going to be 2 plus 1 and 3 plus 1 and 4 plus 1, which will ultimately give the output as 5 at the end. So just a simple program, guys. If you want, you can just type it out and check it. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in Python, C, C++, Java, Node.js, React.js, PyScript, Canva, as well as Blender. So do check the playlist of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.